pretty much doing enterprise creation. And we do this through education. And so they need to, through extensive education, they learn how to maintain it. Along with ownership, it's been proven that if they don't have money invested in their technology, there's a good chance that it's just going to go to the wayside and they're not going to use it, even if it is an effective solution to their problems. Our kind of novel way of creating a sense of ownership is what they do with the revenues generated from additional milk sales and the carbon offsets. What they're going to be doing is then, with those revenues, financing an additional digester project in a local community or a neighboring community.
Alright, so we have the digester. We know the mechanism we want to use to create this self-sustaining project. We've chosen Namawanga, Kenya, and it's in the western Kenyan province, and in the Kakamega district. As you see, their population is roughly around 126,000 people. Only 19,000 of that 126 only have electricity. So I don't even think that's 15% of people in this community have access to electricity. Just to get an insight of, you know, how these people live their lives, as Dan said, living on basically less than $1 a day. There's no roads, there's no infrastructure. They live in semi-permanent homes, huts, and that have 8 to 10 people living in these things. So this project is going to significantly change this